Hello, Shirley Adams for the Sewing Connection, Series 17, Program 12. I saw a wonderful fabric in a shop. It's a very burnished metallic, giving it a kind of an antique look, depending on how the light hits its little tiny pleats. It looks a little between pewter and purple, and intriguing as its appearance is, it feels harsh, and I wouldn't want a whole garment of it. So, buy a small quantity of it to use as an accent fabric. Dream up spectacular uses for it, and even if it's on the pricey side, it'll pay its way. The vest I'm wearing was a remnant left over from the pants I'm wearing, and it seemed to need a little dressing up because it wasn't all that flattering and it wasn't that spectacular, but I can't stand to see a remnant go to waste, and so I thought I'll make a vest. This is the joy of making vests, I think, because you need so little fabric, but it looked so gloomy, and so I thought, let's dress it up a little bit with a lot of metallic stitching on it. So I'll show you after a while how to do all that metallic stitching, all those streaks that I have all over. But what I want to talk about mainly is the accent fabric. And what we were doing, I already had the vest done in that it wasn't finished, it wasn't lined, it wasn't piped around the edge, but I already had the basic, the outside of it done. Very quickly I did it because we were going on a trip. And I hate to waste any time if I sit in the passenger seat. I like to have something to do with my hands to make the trip profitable. And so I just grabbed some of this fabric, the one I was talking about, the little pleated burnished fabric. And I had this, and I had a needle and thread and some pins, and I had no idea what I was going to do with it after I had the initial stitching on the vest. But an idea will come to you if you just leave your mind open, let it be receptive to whatever comes. Well, the first stoplight we stopped at, we were sitting in front of a flower shop, and I thought, oh, of course, make flowers out of it. Now, these don't have to be natural-looking flowers. They're just sort of the idea of flowers. It's a vine of maybe morning glories or something going around it. But this was the easiest thing to do, going around the neck here. And what I decided to do, you know, how do you make flowers like that? Well, who knows? You just do it. You just start playing with the fabric. What I did was cut out a square, and maybe various size squares. But with this square cut out, then it was, okay, here I've got it, make a flower. So what I decided to do, all those raw edges, of course, would have to be turned under. You can see a little bit better as I stretch it out that it's sort of purple when the light hits it just right. Also, when I get through working with this, I find that it rubs off a little bit on my hand. So doubly, I wouldn't want a whole garment out of it. But what I did to make flowers out of this is just sort of crunch the top all together and put it down on the fabric and start stitching. And I'm going to do this upside down so that I can then flip it over, because just to start it right at the top of the flower, the top that would be, or the part that would be attached to the plant, right there, there's a raw edge that needs to be concealed in some way, and I'm using red thread, which I really wouldn't, but just so that you can see the thread is why I'm using a contrast. And so I'll just take a couple of stitches here just to hold it in place. And then after I had it held firmly at the top and all the raw edge there, then you can flip it over and that raw edge is all nicely concealed up there. And then you can easily turn over the side, turn under the edge there, maybe put a pin here and there if you need to, but by the time you have a few pins in this and then do some hand stitching on it, you can see it just fans out at the bottom, is how all these little flowers do. And again there, turn under the edge and stitch that by hand, and I'll get my hands out of here in a minute so you can see better, but it's all just turning under the raw edges every place. So it's really easy to do. A perfect thing to do if you're traveling, if you can stand to look down without getting car sick, which I'm very adept at it by now because I do this so constantly. And you can see how it makes just a nice little fan, a little trumpet flower or a morning glory or something. But turn under all those edges and then just hem it all the way around. And after I got finished, what I had also brought with me, because I thought it kind of went nicely with it, were a lot of bugle beads, kind of a dull pink. And so they also just add a little bit to it. This is just fun. Now, this took a long time because they go all around the neck and down here a little bit. I think we arrived at our destination, so they quit here. But I like that unbalanced look anyway, so that's fine. But this took a long time. It was all the way from Indianapolis down to Florida. And when we got down there, we were doing seminars, but I had a day to just play in between some seminars, so I went shopping. And every shop I went into, you know, these are the pricey little shops in a resort community. Every one I went into, I saw something made out of this identical fabric. And they all have price tags on them that the first thing I saw was a whole lot more than the whole piece of fabric I had bought. Now, I didn't buy very much of this. It was just going to be an accent fabric, so I think I bought maybe a half yard of it or a yard at most, not very much. But all over at these pretty little shops, I saw this. And they were made into such things as this. Here's one. This is a vest clip. And you can buy these in the notions department. They have these. And it just clips onto your vest. Or here, I just have it clipped on a blouse. But these little clips, they have elastic, or they're just the clips is what it is. Just the clips is what you buy, and they're on a package. And you can find them in the where they sell buttons or any of the notions in the fabric shops, you can find these vest clips. And then what I have in between is just a length of elastic and just enough so that I could put that around the clip on each side. And then this is simply covered. There's a seam on the back side. It was simply making a tube of this and turning it right side out and putting it over the elastic, doing a couple of hand stitches or machine stitches on the end just to make sure it doesn't let loose. And then I covered up the end so that they'd look a little prettier with these ribbon flowers. I'll show you how to make those flowers too in a few minutes. So there's one idea I saw in one of the shops. The price tag on this was $45. And I thought, isn't that pretty? I didn't pay that much for the whole piece of fabric, and I just used a little teeny bit here. I just love it when I save that kind of money. Well, in another shop, I saw some really pretty sachet, and I thought, isn't that lovely? Now, won't that be nice? I don't know if I'll just tuck it in a drawer. I'll probably leave it out on top of a chest of drawers because it looks too pretty to tuck away. Or it's also a wonderful hostess gift if you travel and need to take a little something for a thank you. Now, what this is just a square. And this, by the way, is different. You know, when I find a fabric and I get it home, I sometimes realize, oh, no wonder I like that so well. I liked it once before also, and I already have it. But notice that this one has a little purpley cast, and this one is just pewter. So they are two different colors, really. But these things that I have here are made out of the silvery one, the pewter one. Well, what it was just taking a square of fabric. This one probably measures, let me get a measuring device out of my drawer. I just love having this work table with all the drawers and everything handy. A couple of them here for all my measuring and marking equipment. My pressing equipment all goes on the other side, and all my pattern work goes down below. This is so handy. But anyway, this one is about 5 inches long and about 3 inches wide. So that meant the fabric initially was just twice that. And then it's folded in half and just a little seam put in there. Put inside it some fiber fill maybe, and the rest of it sachet, so you have a pretty scent there. And then again, just little flowers. Now this one I made out of the fabric itself. And these I made out of this sort of crinkly fabric. And any kind of thin fabric works well. Organdies, things of that sort would work nicely. And just a little piece of ribbon that's stitched at the top. It was stitched in the seam as I was sewing the top seam. I stitched the top of it and simply cut a V in it here. This other one's the same with some ribbon flowers and another color ribbon. And then in another, I don't remember what those were, but they were a whole lot more than I would have paid, except when it hits you just right and when you're in the mood, you overspend it for some of those things. But those also, each one of them, were more than what the whole fabric cost. And then I saw a pretty little formal purse, and it was nothing but a little gathered drawstring bag. Well, here is one that looks exactly like it. And I put a couple of beads on the end for ballast so it stays in place once you have the knot tied. Now what this is also is just a rectangle of fabric. When it's all straightened out, it's nothing but a rectangle. It's just stitched at the bottom and kind of crunched together there. And it is lined, of course. What I have lined it with is this, by the way, the same kind of crinkly fabric, an organza. What I have it stuffed with right now is just some fiber fill. And what I have done then, after I had the lining in, is just do two rows of stitching here so that I had a channel for the drawstring. And there are actually two of these cords going through. This one goes around from this side to the other. This one goes around from this side to the other so that when you pull, it closes. and it works out well this way. Now, what I also have done is not even use a buttonhole there, which I ordinarily would do, but because of these crinkles in the fabric, it really just covers up nicely, and so all I did was cut a little slit there for the cord to come through, and that was enough. Now, what you could also do is use this for a little travel jewelry bag. That would be nice, and if that's the case, you might want to have this sort of a lining, a velour, or this is just a knit velour fabric. But if you first of all, you know, cut it the same size as the bag, whatever size that is, and you first of all just make a pleat in it like this. Just take a big tuck in the fabric and stitch that all along, and then put it down flat and stitch this way, and you can put a pair of earrings or rings or whatever you want to in each little channel, and that would be around the sides of it. So that would be nice, and then just drop your necklaces down. Again, that was a very pricey little thing. I think the price of this was close to $100, and you know, a sewer looks at it and thinks, you're kidding. We can do that so easily. So I'm just going to take my pins out of this and take it over to the table so I can do some stitching without having any pins interfere. And by the way, I also then just have this vest piped around the edge by cutting a little cross piece so the crinkles were going around it. And there is some yarn going through, of course, to give it a little substance. And that's what pipes all the edge, just because it gives it a nice finished look. So we'll go over to the machine and do a little stitching there. And what I'm going to be doing, first of all, is just look at the picture that I clipped from a magazine there. You know how I keep telling you that anything you see, you can do. Now, it's especially nice if you have the right equipment. Sometimes you can improvise, sometimes, you really can't. But look at that jacket she's wearing. Now, I didn't see the price tag on this. It doesn't say how much it was, but I know who the designer is. So now I know that jacket has to be way over $1,000. I can do that same thing, which I have done on this little bag that I'm making. It's a little clutch bag. It comes from my clutch pattern. And what it is right now is just all like this. And then after you have it all finished, then you fold it up and stitch the sides here, and the flap goes down and you put a little piece of Velcro there or whatever kind of a fastening you want. But it's the very same thing as that extremely expensive jacket. Don't you love it? Aren't you glad you sew? Well, anyway, let me show you how to do this. This is, it kind of looks like, oh, I don't know, like maybe an animal, a skin of some sort, or maybe it looks like the stones in a sidewalk, whatever. Here I have the same fabric, and I have fused to the back of it some fusible fleece, because this holds it out nicely and it gives the substance to the purse as you want it to have. And then I'm going to use a miracle stitcher, which I used last program briefly, and we'll just use that again, because what we were doing last time is a little bit of yarn couched on, but this time I'm going to use this metallic so that it looks exactly like her jacket does. It's this metallic cord, and this is what I'm going to use instead of yarn. Now, I have the machine set already for zigzag stitch, and it's a very narrow stitch. It's only 1.5 because it is also going to be, whoops, I touched it without meaning to. It is also going to be used with this special foot. This is the miracle stitcher that's, you can see the package on the table, but this is the foot that's in that package. And it also has a little cup here that's on the needle screw, and that needle screw comes in the package too. It isn't the one that came in the machine, because the needle screw is round. And so it's all ready to go. Now what I'm doing is just substituting this cord for what I used last time, yarn. And the last time I had the yarn down in my lap and I just twisted it around or just put it around this extra spool pin that I have up here. This time, of course, I can put the spool directly on the spool pin since that's where I want to use it, and I'll use it with this side up so it comes off the back. And I'm going to put this into that little cup at the front of the, in fact, this is a small cord. I might even put it into the smaller cup at the back so that it holds it in place. And then I'm going to put it down here through the slot in the miracle stitch foot, so that, and also the transparent, the monofilament thread is going through the slot. I just have bobbin thread in the bobbin here. And then you put this in. Be sure you have the needle down position, because you don't want it to function at all. You want to just do free motion stitching. And on some fabrics you might do it with a hoop, but the fact that this is all fused to the fleece, it'll do just fine this way. So I'll just start it out by making a little circle and then just go wherever I want to. And I had too much of it here, so I'm going to take it back and wait till I use that up so it picks up the slack. But you can see how easy this is to just go around in whatever direction and get some of that going. Once it gets going, then I'll pick up the slack on it. Okay. Anyway, you can see how you can just make those walls so easily, make it look the same as I did here on the bag. Just go around wherever and make squiggles every place. And if it misses someplace, which it once in a while does, because this is a fine cord, it doesn't catch as easily as heavier yarns do. So if you miss some of it, just go back and do it again, give it a little more yarn. And you can see, you can get this done in a hurry. This probably didn't take me more than, 15, maybe 20 minutes at the most to do the whole purse. So it really is quite fast. And then I piped that also before I was finishing it, sewed a few beads down there. I've been using more and more beads lately because they're such fun to do. And gives it a little extra touch, a little commercial touch. Well then, let me show you how to do this. There are a few ways you can do this to put the cords on. And it might be by also using this miracle stitcher, or it might be just by stitching it directly, and that's what I'm going to be doing. So I'll just take the miracle stitcher off, and let's get the needle up. And once I have this pulled out and cut off, I'll get rid of that, and we'll do a little stitching. I'll leave the same monofilament, I'll leave the same monofilament thread in this time. And let me think what I want to do. I might as well just stitch this cord on. Okay, so I'll keep it here, but I'm going to take the miracle stitcher off because I realize you don't all have one, and so I want to show you that there are other opportunities for doing such things. And put regular foot on, and with that regular shank on, I'm probably going to put a foot that has a little bit of an indentation in the bottom of it so it leaves room for that cord I want to put on. Am I unscrewing it? Yes, I am. There we go. Okay, so I think I'll take off this foot and instead put on one that has an indentation in the bottom so it leaves room for that cord. This would actually be a really good place to hold it in place nicely. It would really be a good place to use another foot. A deep grooved pintuck foot would be good because it would hold that cord in place, but I don't have it on right now, so I'll just do it this way. And what I did to stitch some of these cords on, if they were too big to do it any other way, I have the same one, in fact, in a couple of places. What I did was this, just put it down, put it on zigzag, use a monofilament thread, and I don't know exactly, I want to have, come to think of it, I want to have this time the feed in play. So I'm going to have to pick up the acrylic top and just put the feed dog back up again so that it will make this fabric move. But I'm going to hold the fabric and see if 1.5 is enough. And you never know until you start. And what I want to do with this cord, once it gets caught, okay, I want to keep this cord right in the little V that's in the middle of this foot. If I would use that pintuck foot, it would eliminate that necessity because it would just hold it very well in place and I wouldn't have to do this at all. And just to make sure, I'm going to put it a little wider. I'll put it up to a 2 instead of the 1.5. But you can see how you can just squiggle this around however you want to and go ahead and couch cords on like this. But there is still another way that you can do this, which I did most of my vest. And what that other way is to just stitch directly instead of couching it on, using the actual metallic thread to put on. Now, you can only do this if it's small enough that it'll wind on the bobbin and come up through the throat plate hole. And so if it's small enough to do that, you can do the job. I have a couple of them here already wound on the bobbin. And to do this, you can simply use your bobbin winder and wind it that way. Now, naturally, because this is so heavy, it isn't going to give you a whole lot of cord or thread or whatever it is on one spool, on one bobbin. You're going to have to change it frequently and use up several of them. But I'll just take the one out that's here and put this one in instead. Now, if this is fine enough, then you can actually just put it through the spring there and use tension on it. But if it is not fine, if it's really kind of heavy as this one is, it would just sort of stop it to put it through the tension. It wouldn't work well. And so I'm not going to do that. I'm just going to put it back here and close up the case close up the opening there, and I possibly would use other thread other than this monofilament, but I'm going to use this anyway since it's in here. And I just want to bring that thread up through the hole in the throat plate. Okay, here I'm pulling it up, and once it's through the hole, now there's no tension on this bobbin at all. And when you've accidentally sewn without any tension on the bobbin, you know what happens. Down on the underside, you have little loops, which you don't want if you're sewing a seam because it's going to pull open. But you do want it on this. I'll take the pins out just to make sure I don't hit one. And of course, where you want it to show is on the top side of the fabric. So that means you have to turn it over to do the stitching. And so I'll just do another curvy row this way and see what happens. Now, I don't want it on zigzag this time, so I'm going to go back to straight stitch. And I also want pretty big stitches so they show up better. I'll get it way up to about 3. And let's see what that looks like. So I'm just straight stitching on this. And these cords might overlap, or they might run parallel, or however. But I just want them to sort of curve around. It didn't take me long at all to stitch this vest. It was really a pretty quick job because it just doesn't take very long to do these big stitches. But you can see how easily that does. So if you don't have my wonderful miracle stitcher, go ahead and see if it's small enough cord, you can get it in the bobbin. If it's very large cord, it's not going to do it. You're going to have to, instead of putting it in the bobbin, it's just too big to go around there, then you're going to have to couch it on in some way. Let's also think about how you make the flowers, though, on those that pretty little evening bag or jewelry bag, whichever you use it for, or the sachet. Here I have some of those flowers started. And if I would use this fabric, which I did on the sachet, I would just, because it's all raw edges everywhere, I've cut this on the bias so that it stretches. I would just fold it in half, and I would stitch right along the two raw edges there with the big basting stitch and then draw up the stitch. If I'm using ribbon, which I did for several of those, and here I have some ribbons already stitched and ready to go, and if you're going to do that, mass produce for goodness sake, just do a whole lot of them and have them ready to go so that, again, I can do that as I'm traveling. I can do it in the car, is why I like to have things like this all ready to go. Or, as I've told you before, when my Gabby sister calls, I like to have it at the telephone so that I can do these things. Okay, now what I do with them, it might be doubled over ribbon as this one is. It'll make a little rosebud, so it might be that. Or it might be wider ribbon. Here's the very same ribbon, just used extended instead of folding it over. But the same thing applies. Big stitches, I'm going to draw up one thread. And right at the first of it, you want those little flowers to start and stop neatly. And so I am going to just trim off the extra fabric here that I don't want. And I'd do that at both ends. And then I'd also trim off the extra fabric I don't want on this one that's doubled over. So whatever, what I'm saying is you want it to round off and come to kind of a point, because that's going to be both the center of the flower and the other point is going to be the outside of the flower. So either way, you want to trim that off so it does come to a point here. And then you pull one of these, I'll pull this one. You pull one of them, I don't know at this point which one was the bobbin thread, it always, there. It always pulls easier than the top thread does. And you just draw it up, not too much, or it'll be a really wavy, I better cut these, they aren't together. It'll be a really wavy little flower, just a ruffle almost, if you pull it up too much. So don't pull it up a whole lot, just somewhat. And you might pull a little from the other end too. And when you decide it looks just the way you want to it to, then go ahead and pull the second thread that you hadn't pulled originally, and it's sort of similar to tying a knot. It'll secure it if I can get a hold of the second thread. Here we go. And if I just tug that a little bit, then the whole thing tightens up, and do that on both ends so that it won't change at all. There we go. And then to make this into a flower, you simply wind it around. And at the same time you're winding, you need to stitch. So here's my needle. Let me tie a knot here, and I'll do a little stitching on it to show you how you finish up this flower. And it's just going to be taking a few hand stitches there, not much of anything. No work really involved. Something good for television or whatever. But once you get this started, on the see why I cut it? Because it goes down. The finished edge then just goes down. This is why you cut it to a point. And once you have a couple of stitches here, then you can cut off your threads, the initial ones, and get rid of them since they are just kind of in your way. And I'll take another stitch or two, and then I'll start turning it to show you what it looks like. Try to keep my hands out of the way here as much as possible. Okay, once I pull that in, Then you twist, and you just, every time you get a little twist in here, turn it a couple of turns, and then take a few hand stitches here on the bottom so that you can catch it every turn of the way. And I'll turn it a little bit more and take another couple of stitches. And by the time you finish this whole thing, I would really take more stitches, but I don't want to take any more time, is why I'm doing this quickly. Anyway, stitch the whole thing together at the bottom by hand, just a few stitches here and there. They don't even have to be really neat. You don't even have to use the same color thread, although I usually would. But what you do after you have this all finished is turn this flower inside out, because right now it isn't terribly pretty to have those raw edges down there. And to turn it out, you just sort of peel it back. You just kind of go like this and peel it all the way around. And by the time you get it all peeled, and I didn't catch it all real well there, but by the time you get it all peeled so that it's wrong side out, then the whole flower looks nice. This does as well as the top of it. The whole thing works, and so you put it on your project. Well, I just love the opportunities any given fabric can provide. Next time we'll look at one which offers unlimited options in its many colors. See you then.